Now that we've talked about the at sign, let's talk about the equal sign. So let's switch over here and put in equal, and you'll see automatically that it's going to break. Basically, it's going to throw errors and everything because it's not expecting a string anymore. It's actually expecting an object to combine to, which would be something like that. So you get rid of the double curlies, so it's not an expression anymore. If you refresh, you can see that it's actually bound to that BlackBerry property there. Now, what this is actually doing, it's setting up a binding both ways. So if I were to, instead of having just a div here, if I were to set up an input of text, say ng model, and then bind this to flavor, that's going to say that when I update this, also send that change out to here, through here. So you're actually not going to be able to see this yet, so let's do this too. I'm going to set up another input. This one will be text ng model flavor, and then let's say this one's the controller and this one's the directive. So controller directive, you can see if I update from the controller, and then here this will be from the directive, and that's also sending the updates out to the controller level. So if you look at the, you can think of the equal sign as basically being this is set to that, and whatever changes happen, update them. So you'll never pass in the double binding is in there, because that's just going to send a string. Like in the at sign, it was accepting a string. Here you're going to be sending in a property on a scope to bind to, so that you have the binding happening both ways. That looks like it's about all there is to cover on that. I think that's used a lot less than you probably think it is when you're actually building out directives. Maybe when you're doing little demo things, it might be cool, but I think the at sign and the and sign, which we'll cover next, is used a lot more often than this two-way binding equal thing.